You have to practice. If you don't practice, you won't get paid. Because here's the truth, professionals practice more than they perform. So you have to continually practice. That's the first thing. The second thing is you have to find a starving market. You have to find a starving market. What is that? It's a market that is always looking for high quality speakers.
Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. What's going on, family? Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. And you all know that this is your number one source for podcast news, podcast how-tos. And now the new pillar we're adding on is interviews, right? So welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen. And, you know, I'm excited today to have on a gentleman who I stumbled upon. And then ever since then, I'm just like, how does this guy, first of all, stay busy all the time? Like, my man stays busy on the speaking circuit, stays busy just helping equip people with tools and resources and literally everything that they need to be successful in the speaking market, in the speaking business. I want to introduce to the Your Podcast Mentor Show the one, the only, Mr. Odell Bizzell. Odell, what's going on, brother?
What's going on, big time, man? I'm excited to be here, excited to be in front of your folks.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Well, you know, I had to bring you on because, I mean, you know, you're marketer's favorite marketer, right? So definitely had to bring you on, man, and excited to have you here. But Odell, I just want to just kick this thing off, man, because like I said before, like before we were talking, one thing I can really appreciate about you is you're kind of like, I'm going to say kind of like a Chick-fil-A, man, because you're always just in the people's face. And then when the people don't see you and they don't see you pumping out content, then they want to see you, right? It's like, well, where did he go? I'm familiar with the brother, you know, with the beard. He got the smooth voice and got the cool name. So, man, Odell, how did you even, like, how did this speaking thing even start for you? And, you know, how did you even get into this lane?
Yeah, man. Well, I appreciate that. Everything that you're doing, seeing how you've grown and how you're growing in business and conversations we've had, I just appreciate it. I really got into this. I wanted to be an entrepreneur. And so trying to figure out what that looked like was how I really stumbled upon speaking. Like you, back in the day, I was a hooper. I wasn't as good as you probably, but I was a hooper back in the day. I wanted to play basketball, but really because of the rewards that you can get from it. When I discovered that I wasn't going to go play major D1, when I wasn't going to play in the NBA, I figured, okay, I have to do something that's going to make a lot of money. And trying to figure that out, going through network marketing companies, going through different business opportunities, public speaking was the thing. And because everything that I did, it had some component of public speaking. It had some components of public communication. And I remember when I graduated from college, my public speaking professor, Dr. Pond, he said, hey, what are you going to do with your life? And I had no idea. And so then I asked him, you know, what do you think I should do? And he's like, you should consider being a professional speaker. Now, I'm 22. I didn't know what that was, like public speaker. I'm not famous. I didn't survive a plane crash. I didn't found a tech company and make $1 million with the IPO. I didn't have any of that. And he said, all you need is a message and you need a market that's willing to hear that message. And when he said that, he started leading me down the path to perfect my public speaking craft. You know, Malcolm Gladwell talks about 10,000 hours. I started from that point on. And then I learned the power of public speaking and being able to make money from it. And I haven't looked back since. When you have that skill, when you have a skill set, a lot of people are looking for different venues through real estate, through crypto, through Airbnb. But when you have a skill that you can monetize, that's all that you really need. And then it'll fund all the other stuff that people are looking to get into. So that's kind of how I got through it.
So like, let's just say that, like, if you were to ballpark it, right? If you were to ballpark it and say that through public speaking, you've been able to generate X. Like, first of all, how long have you been public speaking?
I've been paid to speak since 2008. So as of this recording, gosh, it feels a lot. 14 years. 14 years, man. It's crazy.
14 years. In the span of 14 years, Odell, talk some numbers to us, man. Just talk some numbers for the people.
Yeah, so this past year, 2021, we surpassed over $1 million since I started speaking full-time. So I first started part-time in 2008, but full-time in 2013. So you're looking at about 10 years, making just over $1 million this past year.
Man. Okay.
But just from speaking fees. So just from people paying me and, you know, me getting on other people's stages and doing that.
Sweet. That's a lot of reps, man. A lot of paid reps to get to a million. Like that's serious. And the reason I wanted to ask you that is because now I want to take a slight pivot, and because that's what you've done for yourself, right? And I've heard it said many times that if you want to measure somebody's success, don't just look at what they've been able to do once, but look at what they've been able to help others do as well. How many students would you say that you've been able to also help go from, you know, Odell, nobody wants to pay my fee. I'm going to schools and people telling me that they don't have a budget and that they're not looking for speakers. They got the speaker and everything's like, you know, you've heard all the excuses. but how many people would you say that you've helped cross over that, you know, cross over those barriers, and just in terms of helping them go from never been paid or want to be paid to then being in a position to where, you know, they're able to command their fee and they're able to generate what they desire?
Well, I started coaching in 2018 because I didn't want to be one of those people that, well, like you said, oh, I'm doing it for me, so I know how to teach other people. I wanted to be sure. I wanted to teach from experience, not theory. So I wanted to be really sure of that. So I didn't really start coaching until 2018. I've had close to 400 people buy products from me. So that's download a course, masterclass, stuff like that. I've coached personally about 50 speakers or so. From those 50 speakers, I know the ones that I know about, I've helped about 5 of them reach the 6-figure annual mark. And other people have made more, but those are just the people that I know.
Odell, you talking spicy right now, man. You're talking real spicy right now.
Hey, man, we're just getting started, man. We're just getting started.
Good nit. So just taking a step back, what I can say I see from just what you've shared thus far is, one, you took time, you learned, and you mastered something successfully to be able to do it year after year after year after year, right? And then on top of that, then you're like, well, this is tried, this is tested, this is proven. Now let me share the strategy with somebody else and let's see what they can do. And then they double down on it too.
Yeah, that's, and honestly, and I'll say this quickly, people become coaches and that, I mean, we all need coaches at different levels, right? We need coaches at the level that we're getting to. So if you haven't made $1 million in a year yet, you know, maybe you need to reach out to somebody that's making $100,000 or what have you. So there are different levels to it, but I think people jump into coaching before they master the fundamentals of the game. So Phil Jackson, he played in the NBA 1,000 years ago. Of course, most people don't even know that he played, but he played. He was a role player. You know, he wasn't outstanding. He was a role player. He played under some great coaches, but he mastered the fundamentals of the game. So then when he had the great talent of a Michael Jordan, a Scottie Pippen, a Dennis Rodman, a Kobe, a Shaq, when he had those, then he was able to give his mastery of the fundamentals to the master talent. And so I think a lot of coaches, they don't master the fundamentals. And so they're trying to teach based on what they think might work. And I think that can bring a lot of people back. It's not to say that you can't learn anything from anybody, but you have to master those fundamentals. And so that's what I did. And I'm one of those people that is super simple. I like to keep things as simple as possible because I want you to replicate what I've done. And you said it earlier, I'll say it a different way, that success reproduces success. That's something that John Maxwell talks about all the time. Success reproduces success. And so if I'm truly successful, I can't really say until I see one of my clients, hey, I just went over 6 figures for the year. Oh, snap, that's what's up. Hey, we just got 10 speeches booked from your strategy doing this. Wow. It must really work, right? So that's how you can better prove it. And the last thing I'll say about it is public speaking. And because I've taught other people how to be speakers, but what I've really learned is that public speaking is the greatest marketing medium of all time. Hands down, it's the greatest. If somebody, you think about the giants in the game, from an Oprah Winfrey to a Tony Robbins, even to a Larry King, rest in peace. They got famous because they interviewed people. What are you talking about, public speaking, Odell? What do you mean? Public speaking, interviewing is a public speaking skill. So if you really learn public speaking, you can turn it into marketing for whatever business that you have. And that's what I've been able to do here in the last, I'll say, 8 months, helping other businesses get their messages out there, nonprofits, service-based entrepreneurs. Because, and here's the thing, John, the reason why they trust me is because they see me speaking. He's standing in front of a crowd. We're wired to think the person standing in front of the crowd can be trusted. And so when they see that, that's why a cancer fund can come to me and say, hey, Odell, we have this initiative that we want to do. Can you help us with it? And we'll pay you a very handsome contract to do that. Would you be willing to? Sure, of course I would. So that I want people to understand, you know, coaching, get coaching. But make sure the coach is listening, master a fundamental, and then make sure that you sell the process out to get the skill to do that.
Okay. Oh, man, you got my mind going like 3 different ways. It hit like a mixed master of highways from everything that you just said. But I want to rewind back because you're talking to the coach who has, you know, who might be trying to capitalize too soon. But I want to ask you, Odell, what about the starting out speaker? Because now I feel that like never before, and of course, being in the industry, I see so many other speakers. If it's a wellness speaker, if it's a mental health speaker, if it's a DEI speaker, like whoever or whomever it may be, what do you have to say to the starting out speaker? Because I think to the untrained eye, they look, so somebody may have never met Mr. Odell Bizzell II, right? And they look at him and they're like, man, I can do what he's doing. He's up there. I can do that. But they haven't been in your shoes. They haven't had that mic. What do you say to that person who's starting out and who wants to just get started because it looks easy? Talk right to me, Odell. Talk to me.
So greatness usually is the display of a complex activity done effortlessly. So a lot of people, when they see people doing great things or great feats, it looks effortless a lot of times. I recently went to a Charlotte Hornets game. My wife and I got really great seats. We were courtside. And so Melo Ball plays for the Hornets, which is my team. I'm from North Carolina. And so we saw them. We got there early. We saw them warming up. We saw them clowning around. We saw them doing all that. And, you know, again, I hooped back in the day. It's like, yeah, I've done similar things to that, but understanding that how fast the game is on TV, the game looks slower than it is. When you see them in person, oh, it's different. It's like, wow, they just went up and down the court that fast. And so a lot of people from the rafters, from the television screen, oh, that looks easy. Yeah, I can't dunk, but I'm not tall. So yeah, whatever. That looks easy. So the person that is looking to get into speaking, get good. Get really, really good at speaking. And the way you get good is not by going to a seminar. The way you get good is not by listening to somebody teach you how you should get good. The way you get good is by speaking. So speak constantly. I tell my coaching clients all the time, I need to see you speak every day. Speak to just the camera. Speak on an Instagram live when nobody's there. Speak on a clubhouse room. Speak constantly. You have to practice. If you don't practice, you won't get paid. Because here's the truth, professionals practice more than they perform. So you have to continually practice. That's the first thing. The second thing is, you have to find a starving market. You have to find a starving market. What is that? It's a market that is always looking for high quality speakers, but they can't find them. Because the truth is that most people, if you think the word speaker, for those of you listening, we think the word speaker, a name, a venue pops up in your mind. Maybe you're like me, and when you first found out about public speaking, you read Les Brown's book. Probably not Les Brown's book, because that book is 1,000 years old, Live Your Dreams. Maybe you didn't. I don't know. Maybe you heard Eric Thomas's famous, if you want to succeed as much as you want to breathe. Maybe you heard Mel Robbins' 5-4-3-2-1. Whatever it is, whatever drew you in, you've got to understand that that individual, they were sharing something on a platform that I guarantee that somebody paid them to be on. So there's a market that's looking for that type of stuff. And I'm going to go here for the beginners and for anybody in between. You're not in the speaking business. There's no such thing as the so-called speaking business. There is the event business that hires speakers. I'll say that again slowly. There's no such thing as the so-called speaking business. There are events that hire speakers. And so you have to get really good if you're new, if you're trying to transition back into the game. Maybe you fell back off because of the pandemic, or maybe you went to another career and now you're more steady and you can transition. Go where the events are. Why do they hire speakers in the first place? Well, they hire speakers to inspire a crowd. Where's that starving market? That's why I lead people always to the college market, because there's so many opportunities there that people don't even know about. There are people getting paid $5,000 for a 45-minute keynote. There are people that in the college market, in the college space, there are people getting paid $15,000 to do 4 virtual workshops. There's a lot of things, but people are, I want to be in the big, Superdome, or like Les Brown was when he did his Hungary presentation. I want to be there. Start at Walla Walla Community College on a virtual where they're paying you $2,500. Start there, because what that'll do is that'll allow you to get your reps in. that allow you to practice, that allow you to get your reps in where it matters. And then you can elevate and go up, and you have that social proof for people seeing you actually do it. So then they see you doing it. They trust you. Oh, man, Jonathan, I saw you on LinkedIn Live, man. You were talking to an executive of this company, man. You must be smart. They're not saying it with those words, but that's what they're saying. You must be smart. You must know something I don't know. And then you can run up the score in anything else you want to sell.
Okay, Odell. Okay. Okay. So now let's jump back. Let's jump back, because you were talking about just the skill of public speaking, and then you were talking about how this is a tool that you can basically leverage it anywhere you want. It's almost like a utility tool that, you know, can be used to help you get a lot of other jobs done. So now I want to pivot back to the part where you're talking about just like Oprah, Larry King, and them doing interviews. And you have a podcast, and you've done interviews, you've been on interviews. Just talk a little bit about just in terms of interviews and how that's benefited you in your business, and, you know, just a little bit more about your podcast.
Yeah, for sure. So I actually have an industry specific podcast called the NAMCA podcast. I'll talk about that a little bit. And then I have my podcast, Public Speaking Profits, where I talk about how you can turn your annual income into monthly income with public speaking and through events. So podcasting I would say podcasting is the better looking descendant of radio. And so if you understand how radio worked back in the day, there's only certain ways that we're going to be able to take in information. And we only have a handful of senses. So you're either going to see it and hear it, or hear it, or you can just see it by reading it. But you're more than likely you're going to consume something, especially if you're driving, if you're working out, you're going to hear something. So that is a way in somebody's brain. And what you have to understand, the power of interviewing is a public speaking skill. So I outlined there are actually four public speaking skills. Interviewing is one of the top ones, because when you're interviewing, it mimics a conversation. We all eavesdrop. We've been doing this since we were kids. Like, oh, what's mom and daddy talking about? What they talking about? Oh, we about to go to Disney. Oh no, ain't got no money. Like, you know, you're listening. Always want you're lurking. Kids do it. My kids do it anyway. Always listening. And so you're kind of listening to somebody having a conversation publicly. And odds are they're having a conversation about something that you're interested in. So it's a better looking descendant to radio, because you can actually pick and choose what you want to listen to. So that's the first point. So you can use it as a way, again, to market yourself. That's why I say public speaking is the greatest marketing medium of all time. If you're interviewed on a bunch of podcasts, if you go to my website, publicspeakingprofits.com, you scroll down, you'll see a handful of all the interviews. Even if you didn't know me, you would see, oh, man, he's been on Social Proof Podcast. Oh, man, he's been on Entrepreneur on Fire. Oh, man, he's been on Wealthy Speaker. Wow. You ain't never met me before. You ain't talked to me. And so that puts something in people's minds. Again, I know what I'm talking about, or this person knows what they're talking about. So you can use it as a marketing medium to increase your social proof, to increase the amount that you can charge people. But here's where it gets really good, John. Like, this is, I want everybody to lean into what I'm about to say. I want you to just pause a little bit. If you're washing dishes, I want you to just dry the dishes. Like, don't wash so you scramble a whole bunch of water. I just want you to listen to this for a second. Interviewing your ideal client is the fastest way to pay. Nobody does this. I started sharing this in 2018. Because I started doing it in 2017. Interview your clients, because we're all pests to people that don't know us. All entrepreneurs, you are a pest. You are a telemarketer. My office is in grandma's basement. They target elderly people like crazy. Before 9 o'clock, the phone will ring 10 times and it'll be the same people calling. That's a pest. We're seen as pests. You might think, oh, no, I'm a speaker. I'm passionate. God gave me this message. You're a pest. John the Baptist was a pest. Jesus was a pest. Like people, they don't want to buy into what you're doing because they don't know you. They don't have it from your perspective. So if you interview people that you want to work with or that you have worked with, here's what happens. You don't turn into a pest. You turn into an expert. Okay, I'm going to go into it. So the NAMCA podcast, I would challenge you to a study. So NAMCA, the National Association of Masterminds and Co-Curricular Advancement, is an association that me and my business partner, Stan Pearson, founded. I'm giving you the secret right now. All NAMCA is, it's a training arm for the people that we want to hire us. And it's a lead opportunity for the people that want to hire us. So we train them and we give them an opportunity to be seen. So with the NAMCA podcast, I interview people. Here's what's cool. They don't even know what I do. When they meet me, because the people that aren't my ideal clients, I simply reach out to them. My team reaches out to them on LinkedIn. Hey, Jonathan, I see that you're in higher education. That's phenomenal. Would you like to be interviewed on my podcast? ? Me? We always get messages like, well, I don't know what I could add. Can I listen to an episode to kind of see how it goes? 8 times out of 10. Some people will be like, no, I'm transitioning out. I'm whatever. No. But some people will be like, oh my gosh, I would love to contribute. Sure. So we get on just like we're on now. Interview. I say, hey, what's up? It's good to meet you for the first time ever in life. So this is what NAMCA does. This is what we do. This is who it's for. Yeah. You ready? Cool. Let's jump into it. We start talking. There was a young lady I interviewed. She attended a mansion retreat that we had. We had a leadership retreat in a mansion for them. I asked her at the mansion. I said, did you even know that I was a speaker? She said, no. She had no idea. So, Odell, what are you talking about? If they don't know what you... Here's the thing. They get to know you. They get to like you. And here's how you turn it into income for you in a fast way. You do one or two things. You interview your previous clients, like the people that you've worked with before. You interview them, say, hey, I'm doing this special project. I'm doing this special Facebook Live, doing this special YouTube channel. I'm doing this special podcast, whatever. And I just want to interview my all-star clients because you are amazing to work with. You have about 15 minutes for us to just chop it up and talk about you and talk about your experience. Boom. That's usually an easy in. So you ask those people. At the end of that interview, you click in record or in of the live or in broadcast, and you say, hey, thanks so much. I really appreciate you. When the episode comes out, I'm definitely going to share it with you. I wanted to get your opinion about something. I'm thinking about creating a new program for XYZ ABCD. What do you think about that? They just answered a whole bunch of your questions. You just made them feel good about themselves. They're going to give you some kind of opinion. They're going to say, oh, I think that's good. Or, yeah, let me think about that. Okay, great. Would you be opposed to me sending you some information about it once I kind of figure it out? Well, of course I would. See, now what you've done, somebody that's paid you money already, they owe you something. They owe you. So you're not a pest. If they avoid your call, if they avoid your message now, they feel bad. Oh, man, let me get back to them. Let me get back. And if your offer is compelling enough, they'll do it. If you don't know, if you don't have any previous clients, all you do, you connect their industry or their job title, whatever, and say, hey, I would love to get your opinion about XYZ based on what you do. Is that cool to hop on a podcast or something like that? then you just do the same thing and you meet a new stranger at the end of, you do the same thing at the end of that recording. Hey, I want to appreciate, I appreciate you so much. We just spent 20 minutes talking. I want to ask your opinion about something. Then what you've done, something that nobody in your industry is going to do. You're giving them attention. You're giving them admiration. So then in return, they're going to either give you money or give you a referral. Very rarely will that person totally ghost you. And if they do, that's not the type of person you want to work with anyway.
Oh my goodness. If you didn't pause and stop washing the dishes, stop folding the clothes, stop driving the car, just pull over or something, Odell literally just gave you all the game and a picture perfect definition of the law of reciprocity. Because when you do something for somebody, just like you said, they feel indebted to you. And Odell, just like you said, being working and speaking within the college market, this is a market where people do not feel as valued as they really are because of the work that they do and just they just putting in some long hours. Oh my goodness. Odell.
Yeah, man. And once you do it, like once you get a machine going, you can do a reunion. Everybody that you've interviewed on the podcast, and we, you know, Jonathan, me and you know people is like, oh, everybody's been on the podcast. Come to this party or come to this event. Wow. Again, events. Notice that events. You bring people together. Hear me and hear me well. This is something that you should write down. This is something that you should think about henceforth forever and ever. Amen. If you want to increase your conversions, increase or create immersion. The greater immersion that your prospect has with you and your content, you and your personality, the more likely they are to convert to a paying customer or client or to somebody that will refer you. I'm telling you what I know, not what I read. The more, and you know it. Everybody knows it. You spend more money with the people you spend more time with. That's just how it is. And anybody, if you've joined a high-level mastermind before, odds are the reason why you joined it was because you spent a lot of time either with the leader of that mastermind or somebody within the mastermind. And you're like, man, that really makes sense because you spent time. And so if you can create those moments through events where you spend more time with your clients, more, it's just going to make sense, especially if your offer is good, especially if you use public speaking in which the way we were talking about.
And then also what you're saying is, if people get to know you and then they appreciate the person, they naturally want to send business your way. Because it's like, oh yeah, I want to send you business. Second of all, if people enjoy being around you, and Odell, I know you know this, but just the fact of when you bring a speaker into an institution, it's a lot of trust that contact has in the person that they're bringing in. That's why they're very, very, very strategic on who they're like, okay, well, we'll take you, or no, you're bothering me, so I'm not going to bring you in. I don't want to talk to you. But people, I guess sometimes, you know, we just don't understand that, especially early, you know, mass email, mass phone call. Hey, can I speak to such and such? No, you can't, because I don't know you. And I know that you're just trying to get in contact with me just so you can speak. So they're reaching with their hand out versus reaching, handing something over.
For sure. And if people think that you're only about money, they will run from you. And the best way to not appear to be like that is to not be like that. And see, I know it's hard because when I first started, and Jonathan, you kind of alluded to it just now, I was just like, yo, I need this contract. I need to get this money. I need to do this. I got to pick it up and put it down. Like, I got to hurry up and get through this, man. I got to do it. I got to hustle. I got to grind. I got to do whatever. And you don't take the time to say, well, instead of me wanting to go speak 50 times, instead of me wanting to get 50 high paying clients, why don't I make 50 really good relationships? Why don't I do that? Because then every relationship is not going to lead to a contract, but it's going to lead to somebody else to lead to somebody else for a contract. And so if you just have it in your mind, it's like when I used to counsel young people about, dating and stuff like that, because they'd ask, my wife and I, we've been married going on 14 years. It'll be 14 years in May. And so I'm like, oh, y'all got married so young. Like, what did you do? How did you do? And I said, look, in the courting process, I never brought up sex. What? How? I know you were thinking about it. Of course I was. I am a man with working parts. Of course I was. But I'm not going to bring it up. You know why? Because everybody else that she was talking to was probably bringing it up eventually. So don't talk about it. Just be there. Be present. Oh, I know. They sending emails. They bothering you. I know. I was like that before. Don't be so hard on them. I was like that too. Don't be like that. Then, hey, you're my friend. Hey, I've told people. I said, hey, don't hire me. Like, hire my coaching. Don't hire me. Hire my coaching clients. What do they end up doing?
Hiring you.
Hey, Odell, do you have any free? I mean, yeah, of course. Yeah, we can work it out. But it's hard if you need the money. I get it. If you need the money, it's really hard. But if you can be patient just for a little bit and build those relationships, those 10 relationships will turn into $20,000 contracts, the 50 relationships. And then you'll look back and you'll see hundreds of people like, wow, this is what I built.
Man, that, see, and I'm glad you hit on that. I'm glad you hit, even though it's crazy, Odell, because it's like, these are things that are hidden in plain sight, like legitimately hidden in plain sight. And these are things that have been said time and time and time and time again. But I'm grateful for you because you market things in a different way than it's typically seen. That's why you're your marketer's favorite marketer. Because, just talking with you and you just sharing some strategy with me. And I was like, what? I've never thought about what you just said. And then just it's applying the strategy, but then sticking with the strategy. Speaking is farming. People have to understand, like, it's legitimately farming. Because you've been in the industry like 14 years. Or you've been married 14 years. Well, speaking 14 years too. I've been in the industry like 7, and now I'm realizing that the people that I have the best relationships with, that I can lean into them, and I'm like, hey, you know what, like, what's going on? What's the challenge that y'all have or something like that? And then they appreciate the relationship, and then they have trust in you to where they're like, hey, it's this topic. Can you speak on this? Do you mind talking about this? Or so... People just got to invest, man.
Big time.
You just got to invest. Man, okay, so talking about investing and everything that you got going on, Odell. Man, what's new? What's coming up? What you got? Because one thing that I will say, just to qualify you, even though I know I don't have to, it's the fact that I told you before, I purchased something from you. Like, I've purchased, one of your offerings, one of your products, and I'm like, hold on, wait. You're trying to tell me in this program, he walks you through a training, then also in this program, he has contacts with numbers, with email addresses. I'm like, I was going to create a speaker program, but I don't want to do it no more. I promise you, Odell, I kid you not. I kid you not. I was going through it for a second. I was just trying to find my space when they were shutting down all the events and stuff. And I'm like, how is Odell still getting booked? What is going on? I don't know if I want to speak anymore, man. What is happening? So, Odell, talk to us, man.
But, yeah, what's coming up, man? And you talked about a program. I don't really offer it anymore. But it's really all about positioning yourself the right way with people that can pay you. So what I have coming up, I have a live event, depending on when you're listening to this, depending on when you're watching this, I have a live event coming up in person, March 18th through the 20th. It's called Words to Wealth Live, how to turn your annual income into monthly income. And I'm going to be walking through a variety of things, three pillars of guaranteed profit. I'm going to be talking about the number one way to set yourself apart in your industry, whatever it is. And I'm going to be breaking down strategies. A lot of people, when they do these events, they do events in the, they're very calculated in how they do it. So they'll share just enough for you to feel like you learned something. And then when you leave with the t-shirt, with the swag bag or whatever, you're like, wow, I don't really, what do I do? Or where do I start? And then you got to figure out dinner, and then you go to the movies, and then you forget. And so what we're going to do is we're going to walk you through the psychology of how you're going to make your annual income into monthly income. But then we're actually going to break down how to do it, so you know with absolute certainty, I can implement the strategy. Like we talked about one of the strategies on this episode, but breaking it down even further, like what's that look like? What's the initial contact look like? How do I follow up with them? How do I have an offer to give them? What does that look like in my industry? We're going to break all of that down for you so that you can use it. And so you'll walk away with a playbook on what to do. And for those that are interested, we'll have an offer for you. But I know based on the curriculum that I have set out for the event, it's going to, and this is a guarantee I have, if you're interested in coming, if you don't feel like you got 10 times the ticket, I'll give you your money back and I'll pay for your travel and I'll pay for your lodging. Just because I'm not saying that to be, you know, haughty, to be anything like that. I know for sure if you're in business, if you're a barber, if you're a stylist, if you're a salon, you can use public speaking to explode your income. I know it. I've seen it. So that's why I'm super excited about that. If you happen to be listening to this and it's past the event or it's too close and you can't get to it, make sure you check out publicspeakingprofits.com where I share all the stuff that we're going to be talking about and we have talked about.
Man, there it is. He said he eliminating all the barriers. He said if you don't feel that you got 10 times, he going to get the ticket, he going to get the flight, and he gonna get the lodging. That's what you said, Odell. You said,
yeah, it's on the website. If you go to fromwordstowealth.com, I say it in the video and I say it on there, because I'm that confident. Because really, Jonathan, it's all about your activity. And I think a lot of times we take part in administrative activities, but not income producing activities. So there's a lot of things we try to do. Because maybe we have to, right? Maybe we're a solopreneur. Maybe we feel like we have to do, but if you focus on the income producing activities, then you can catch up on the administrative side, or you can hire a VA to help you with the administrative side. But income producing activities, they bring money in, they bring clients in, and then you can outsource whatever you need after that.
Man, there it is. There it is. You heard it from the one and only Odell A. Bizzell. The second. Man. Okay, Odell. Okay. Well, Odell, we're gonna get ready to let you run. But man, but before we do that, I know you gotta go pick up the kiddos from school. You know, family first, first ministry. But before we let you run, man, I wanna just run you through a little bit of rapid fire. I wanna have just a little bit of fun, you know, just a couple of questions, just to let the people see a different side of you. So are you ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. And here we go. Beaches or mountains?
Mountains.
Okay. What's the most underrated cereal?
Underrated cereal?
Underrated.
Oh, gosh. Man. Raisin Bran Crunch.
Hey, I was about to say, because I know you love your cereal. Okay, here we go. Here's a really good one. Who would play you in the movie of your life?
Ah! Well, gosh, I don't know. It's funny. I make in my intro video, I have like a voiceover saying that there's a movie coming out about my life, and the person that plays me is Kevin Hart.
Hey, if it works, it works, you know? It works. Music or podcast?
Whoo, gosh. Podcast. But I love music, but definitely podcast.
Smart man. Final two questions. Cake or pies?
Cake.
Okay, what type of cake?
Good cake. I'm partial. There's an Oreo cake by this bakery. I love it. It's an Oreo cake. Eat it all the time.
There it is. And then last question, ninjas or pirates?
Ninjas.
Why ninjas?
I don't know. I used to want to be a ninja turtle, man. So it's just ninjas, and they're unseen. You know, they sneak in and out. They know martial arts. They're silent assassins, man.
I got you. All right, Odell, well, I'm about to do a quick commercial, and then I'm about to come to you for just your final thought, and then also where people can just connect with you, stay in contact with you, everything like that. But, man, I just want to let people know that you heard Odell just say it. Y'all heard him say it about interviews. And if you have not started your own podcast, I want to encourage you, just go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com. Sign up for the free training that we have. I'm going to show you on the training how you can start the podcast, and then ultimately from doing that, how you can establish your authority, even if you don't have a lot of followers. So go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com. Odell, final word for the people, man. Final word. What you got for us, Doc?
Yeah, I would just say this, that it is your duty to become wealthy with what's inside your brain. We live in a time in which there's so much information, there's so much distractions. But the reason why I say it's your duty is because think about how you would feel if you could hear or read the thoughts, the emotions, the feelings of your great-grandparents. Just think about that. Most people didn't have that opportunity. Especially if they're, you know, my age, in their 30s or a little older, you have that opportunity now. Your words can not just breathe life into your clients so that they can make money or they can get the result that they want, but your family. They can read, they can listen, they can watch your podcast, they can watch your interviews, and they can know you. And the people that don't even meet you in your family can get to know you. And that's our first role. That's our first ministry, is for the people we're assigned to. And so it's your duty to become wealthy with your words, not just wealthy in what you have in your hands, but wealthy in what you're able to share with the world.
Mm. Folks, there it is. There it is, from the one and only Odell Bizzell the second. Y'all, he has this amazing event coming up, phenomenal event. We're going to have the link down in the show notes where you can click it, where you can get registered, and then also where you can find out more information. But if you go on the page, you need to just be ready to just buy your ticket, because the next time you come back to the page, it's going to be sold out. I just wanted to let y'all know. Odell, my brother, I appreciate you taking the time and stopping by and rocking with us, man. So thank you so much for gracing us with your presence and with your wisdom, as always.
Appreciate you, man. Keep doing God's work.
Most definitely. And to all the listeners out there, we definitely appreciate you taking the time to listen, to rock with us, to tune into this episode of the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. And remember, we're here to help you establish your platform so that you can profit on purpose with your podcast. Peace and God bless.